Hello everyone and welcome back to Microbial Concepts. So this is the channel where we study about microbiology and all the theory and practical related topics. So there are many videos which are uploaded on my channel, so you can watch those videos. If you are struggling with any particular topic which you find difficult to get notes to get your concept clarified, then mention that topic in comment box, or you can reach me out by Gmail. That is also mentioned. My Gmail ID is also mentioned in description box. Okay, so today we are going to discuss about mRNA processing in eukaryotes. So we know about the central dogma, right? That is the basics that we are taught in our first year, that from DNA with transcription process we get RNA, and after RNA getting translated we get proteins. So that is the central dogma. Okay, in each and every living cell, this is what is the sequence that is followed. Now, today we are going to discuss about RNA, focusing on mRNA particularly. So, there are three types of RNAs which are found in living cells. That is mRNA, messenger RNA, tRNA, transfer RNA, and ribosomal RNA, that is rRNA. So, transcription, it occurs in nucleus in eukaryotic organism, while translation occurs in the cytoplasm and endoplasmic reticulum. Now, in case of prokaryotes, transcription and translation, it occurs in cytoplasm itself, as there is no nucleus present in prokaryote. Okay, so both these processes takes place in cytoplasm. In case of eukaryotes, transcription takes place in nucleus and translation occurs in cytoplasm and endoplasmic reticulum. So this is the basic difference, okay, with these processes of central dogma. Now we are going to focus about eukaryotes. So in the nucleus, we know that where the transcription takes place. So transcription is the process from which we get RNA, that is mRNA. Okay, so a pre-mRNA, that is pre here means it is premature. Okay, so a premature RNA is produced through transcription of a region of DNA from a linear chromosome. Okay, now eukaryotes, they have linear chromosomes, and prokaryotes, they have circular chromosomes. Okay, now this transcript must undergo. Transcript is what? The pre-mRNA. It should undergo processing. Okay, why processing? Because it is raw. Now splicing and addition of 5 prime cap and poly A tail at 3 prime is what is necessary, or that is the processing here. So while it is still in nucleus in order to become a mature mRNA. So this everything happens in the nucleus. Okay. So eukaryotic mRNA protein coding sequence are not continuous as they are in the prokaryotes. So prokaryotic mRNA doesn't need this kind of processing, but eukaryotic mRNA, it does. The coding sequence are exons and are interrupted by non-coding introns, which must be removed to make a transferable mRNA, right? So third point here to remember is exons and introns. That is the most important point in the mRNA processing in eukaryotes. So exons are one which are coding parts or the coding sequences, and introns are ones which are non-coding, or they are also known as interrupting non-coding sequences. Okay, that means they are of no use. Now about eukaryotic mRNA, which last for several hours, whereas prokaryotic mRNA, it lasts for no more than 5 seconds. Okay, why? Because here translation, transcription, they both occur simultaneously, but in case of eukaryotes, it is not the case. Now, pre-mRNA are first coated in RNA stabilizing proteins. These protect the pre-mRNA from degradation while it is processed and exported out of the nucleus. The three most important steps of pre-mRNA processing are addition of stabilizing proteins, just we have saw that, then signaling factors at the 5 prime, 3 prime end of the molecules, and then removal of introns. Okay, now about 5 prime capping. If you have a doubt about what are these stabilizing proteins, so these RNA stabilizing proteins, they are very important as they protect the pre-mRNA degradation, okay, while it is still being processed. So we need these stabilizing proteins. So this was the first important step. Now, when it is still getting processed, the second step, important step, is signaling factor at 5 prime, that is 5 prime capping. Okay, so while the pre-mRNA is still being synthesized, a 7-methyl guanosine cap, okay, it is also known as M7G, okay, it is the cap that is added to 5 prime end of the growing transcript. Now, transcript is the mRNA which is still getting transcribed by the 5 prime to 5 prime phosphate linkage. So you can see here, this is the 5 prime end of the mRNA. So at the 5 prime end, there is the 7-methyl guanosine cap getting attached. So the structure of cap. So capping of the pre-mRNA involves the addition of 7-methyl guanosine, M7G, to the 5 prime end. The cap protects the 5 prime end of the primary RNA transcript from attack by ribonuclease. So ribonuclease are enzyme which degrades the RNA. Okay. So ribonucleases, it protects from the attack of ribonucleases and is recognized by eukaryotic initiation factors involved in the assembling of ribosome on the mature mRNA prior to the initiation of translation. So it also has 5 prime cap also has a function in initiation of the translation. Okay. Now about the 3 prime poly A tail. So you can see here a 5 prime cap is added. So this is the second step and it is still getting continued. So you can see here, while the RNA polymerase 2 is still transcribing, so the transcription is not completed. The RNA polymerase is still transcribing downstream of the proper end of a gene. The pre-mRNA is cleaved. You can see here, a pre-mRNA is cleaved at this point by endonucleases containing protein complex. So the ribonucleases means endonucleases will cleave at this point as they contain protein complex between AAU-AAA consensus sequence and a GU-rich sequence. Okay, so between these two sequences, there is a site where a ribonucleases, it cleaves the pre-mRNA. And this releases the functional pre-mRNA. So you can see here a pre-mRNA, that is functional mRNA, the one that we required for the processing, is released from the polymerase, okay, from the rest of the transcript that is still attached to the polymerase. Now an enzyme called as poly-A polymerase, that is PAP, is a part of the same protein complex that cleaves the pre-mRNA. So a part of this endonuclease or ribonuclease is a poly-A polymerase. What does this enzyme does, or it do? It adds the A's to the 3 prime end, or 200 A nucleotides. Okay, so a poly-A tail is added at the 3 prime end of the just cleaved pre-mRNA. So this is the 3 prime poly-A tail. Okay, this is the 5 prime cap. Now this is ready for splicing. Okay, the poly-A tail protects the mRNA from degradation and aids in the export of mature mRNA to the cytoplasm and is involved in binding proteins involved in the initiating translation. Okay, so 5 prime end, 5 prime capping and 3 prime poly-A tail both have initiation. They are involved in the initiation of translation and they also protect from the degradation of the pre-mRNA. Okay, that's the function. Now about pre-mRNA splicing. Now we have the pre-mRNA capped and poly-A tail added to it. So it is ready for splicing, the third important step. So eukaryotic genes, they are composed of exons which correspond to protein coding sequence. So you can remember it as XEX. It signifies that they are expressed, okay, on translation. an intervening sequence called introns. So introns, it denotes that intervening role. Okay, means they don't have any function, but they will just interrupt your sequence, and they may be involved in some kind of gene regulation, but they are removed from the pre-mRNA during processing. So intron sequences in mRNA, they do not code for any functional proteins, and that's the reason to minimize our workload from the cell, we remove introns. Okay, we means the cell removes introns. Now intron processing. All the introns in the pre-mRNA must be completely and precisely removed before protein synthesis. If the process makes errors by even a single nucleotide, the reading frame in the translation, it goes wrong. And what happens? The reading frame of the rejoin exons would shift, and the resulting protein would be dysfunctional, or it will be of no use, as there is a frame shift. We can't say mutation, but the frame reading got wrong. Okay, and that's the reason the protein that was supposed to be functional, it became dysfunctional. The process of removing introns and reconnecting exons is called splicing. Introns are removed and degraded while the pre-mRNA is still in nucleus, and the splicing of pre-mRNAs is conducted by the complex of proteins and RNA molecules called spliceosome. Now we will be studying about removal of introns by spliceosomes. So pre-mRNA splicing. So you can see here, so this is a spliceosome which has 5 subunits. Okay, these 4 circles and one is at the backside. So there are 5 subunits which are called as SNRNPs. Okay, this is the green part is the intron, and you can see there are 2 exons. Okay, exon 1 and exon 2. So between 2 exons there is a intron, and we want to remove that intron. So pre-mRNA splicing involves the precise removal of intron from the primary RNA transcript. The splicing process is catalyzed by large complexes called spliceosomes. Each spliceosome is composed of 5 subunits called as SNRNPs. The spliceosome's action results in the splicing together of the 2 exons, okay, and the release of intron into lariat form. So intron is removed and then it is degraded, and the remaining 2 exons, they are joined together. So how it works? So each spliceosome is composed of 5 subunits, we have seen that, and each SNRNP is itself a complex of proteins and a special type of RNA which is found in nucleus called SNRNAs, small nuclear RNAs. Okay, now the spliceosome, they recognize the sequence at 5 prime end. Okay, so they will recognize the sequence at 5 prime end of the intron, because intron always starts with the nucleotide GU. Okay, and it will recognize the sequence at 3 prime end, where it ends with nucleotide AG. Okay, so this is the 3 prime end, this is the 5 prime end of the intron. Now the spliceosome cleaves the pre-mRNA sugar phosphate backbone at the G that starts the intron, and then covalently attaches the G to an internal A nucleotide within the intron. So what will happen? Phosphate backbone at this G is cleaved, and that GU or the G will get covalently attached to a A nucleotide which is internally present in that particular intron itself. Now you can see a loop is formed here. Then the spliceosome connects the 3 prime end of the first exon to the 5 prime end of the following exon. So this is the 5 prime end of the exon, this is the 3 prime end of the exon. So the 3 prime end of this first exon is now connected to the 5 prime end of the second exon, and cleaving the 3 prime end of the intron in the process. So when these two are getting joined together, the 3 prime end of intron is getting spliced, okay, and it is released. So this is how the pre-mRNA is processed and we get a mature mRNA which just consists of exons with 5' cap and 3' poly A tail. Okay, so this was all about mRNA processing in eukaryotes. So I hope this concept is clear to you all, and I hope you like my videos. Do give a thumbs up, do share my videos with your friends, and do subscribe to my channel. Thank you.